It was my 8th birthday when I first realized that something was very wrong with me. "What's wrong, honey?" But I didn't reply. I stared in horror at what was before me. At first, everyone was worried, but when I pointed to what had scared me, everyone started laughing, and Dad angrily left the room. "She's scared of balloons." "Hi, my name is Samantha, and I'm really scared of balloons. I mean, deathly terrified. There's even a term for it, globophobia. I've had it since I was a kid, and it's one of the reasons my dad doesn't really like me. But before I continue, don't forget to subscribe to My Story Animated."
"You are so dumb. This is the 5th game you've lost."
I burst into tears. My opponent was 5 years older and captain of the high school chess team. Of course she won. But Dad wasn't having it. He said that I was just a dumb kid. He still seemed angry about the balloon thing from the previous week. Just then, my brother ran in and reenacted the scene from my birthday. It was so annoying. My mom got me deflated balloons and I told her they didn't scare me, but as soon as she started blowing them up, I threw a tantrum and left. They just didn't understand. When my fear didn't go away for the next few months, Dad dragged me to a doctor who checked me over and said there was nothing to be done. "She's scared and that's that." Dad lost his temper and stormed out. A few months later, when I came home from school, I saw my parents arguing very loudly in the living room. "I'm never enough for you, am I? I work day and night, but you never appreciate it.
Don't you dare pretend you're the victim. I know what you've done. I just don't have the proof, but I'll get it one day."
They even mentioned my name a few times. The next morning, we found Mom lying on the couch surrounded by ice cream and junk food. Her hair was a mess, and she looked like she'd been crying all night. Dad was nowhere to be found. Slowly, my uber-thin mom started to gain so much weight, eventually she could barely even move. Looking after Cody suddenly became my job, and Dad just made things worse. He would only come home to yell and eat and be mean. He kicked Mom out of their room and forced her to sleep on the couch. He kept on calling me stupid and ugly.
"I don't know who you take after. You disgust me."
The only person he didn't hate was Cody. When I was in the 8th grade one day, Cody didn't come home from school, and my dad kept acting like it was somehow my fault. He told me to go look for him and not come home without him. I was scared to go alone, so I asked my mom to come with me, but she just rolled over on the couch. I couldn't stop thinking about all the horrible things that could have happened to him. It was starting to get dark, and that's when a creepy guy walked up to me and said, "You look lost, little girl. Come with me and I'll take good care of you." I tried to keep my voice from shaking as I said no, and turned and ran as fast as I could. Suddenly, I realized I was lost. I was really tired, and slept in an alley next to a dumpster.
"Wake up! Hey, kid!"
I opened my eyes and found a blonde-haired boy looking at me. He looked familiar. I asked him who he was, and he simply said,
"Get up! This is no place to sleep."
Then he dragged me home. He was a few years older than me and said he'd seen me around. He looked so worried, it made me feel kinda warm inside, but when I turned to thank him, he was gone. Inside, I saw Cody sitting in the kitchen. My dad saw me and laughed loudly. Then he handed Cody $5.
"That was the best idea you've ever had."
My brother's smile widened. I was so angry I headed up to my room, but my dad shouted that I was late for school and forced me to go there smelling of garbage. I had to stop at a friend's place to shower. A few months later, after a really nasty fight with Dad, I skipped school and decided to visit the local carnival. It seemed like a great idea until I got there. As soon as I walked in, a clown jumped in front of me and laughed.
"What are you doing here alone, little missy?"
But I couldn't reply. I was staring at something far, far scarier in his hand. A balloon! I was about to scream when someone snatched the balloon and deflated it. Then I felt an arm around my shoulder as someone whispered,
"It's okay. It's gone now. It's gone. Breathe."
I finally regained some clarity and looked at my savior and jumped in fear. "Oof, the mask scared me." He laughed and took off the mask. I stared in shock. It was the same guy who'd taken me home when I was lost. "You, are you following me?"
"Yes." No, my uncle owns this carnival. I'm helping out."
I asked him who he was.
"I'm Tom. I live across the road from you, silly. I was at your birthday too. The one who blew up the balloons that terrified you. I'm sorry."
Then he stayed with me as I roamed the carnival. Every time he saw a balloon, he'd tell me to close my eyes, and then he would hold my hand as we walked past them. By the time I got home, I knew I was in love. On the day of my 14th birthday, I had decided that after school, I would ask Tom if he loved me. But as soon as I got to school, I screamed and tried to run back out, but the door was locked. One of the kids outside yelled, "Happy birthday, freak!" I just couldn't take it anymore. Suddenly, I heard a noise and the door flew open. I looked up scared, but it was Tom.
He helped me up and told me to close my eyes. Then he led me outside. As soon as we left, I realized I couldn't do it. I could never tell him I loved him. He probably thought I was a freak, too. I mean, he lived with balloons. Sure, he'd put up with me now, but for all I knew, he just felt very sorry for me. The next day at school, I started to find small gifts and little cards in my locker. Were they from Tom? Before I could investigate, though, COVID-19 happened and I was stuck at home. My dad decided his new hobby was going to be messing up my Zoom classes. One time, he swore at me for no reason and the entire class heard it. And it was the worst. Ranting over the phone was just not the same. In one class, my teacher got up for something and someone said, "Hey, Sam, you were right. She does have a lopsided butt." My teacher was livid. I didn't know who it could be until I heard Cody and my dad laughing like crazy in the next room. Cody got some chocolate for suggesting that great idea. That night, I heard a sound coming from our storeroom. I found my mom there crying and looking into some kind of chest. I was stunned. Mom hadn't left the couch in years. When she saw me, she quickly jumped up and yelled at me to get out. I saw her lock the door and go back to lying on the couch and eating ice cream straight from the tub. When I woke up the next day, I could hear my dad's voice coming from his room. He was laughing, but who was he talking to? I tiptoed to his door. I was surprised to see him in front of the computer wearing his best shirt and looking very styled. He had no pants on, though. He heard me shuffle by the door and suddenly shut his laptop and told me to mind my own business. I heard my mom angrily yell from the next room, "Samantha, leave that jerk alone. It's not like he's doing anything new." I was smart enough to put together the clues and guess that he was cheating on mom. But what lady in her right mind would want to date him, of all people? A few days later, I was taking my math class, and the teacher decided to give me a one-on-one lesson because he said I was struggling a little. My dad crept up behind me and laughed at my teacher. "Why are you wasting your time on this idiot?" Instead of things getting awkward, my teacher got mad. "Why don't you just shut up? Just because you failed at your job doesn't mean I can't do mine." My dad stood silently for a moment, turning red. Then he walked away furiously. Since then, I wasn't allowed to take my math classes. He made sure of that. I got my first chance to catch up with a class when my dad wasn't home one day. I hurriedly found the link and clicked on it. I realized that I had accidentally joined my science class. There was no class going on, but I could hear the teacher giggling like a teenager from somewhere behind the screen. "I have to start in 10 minutes, so don't be so naughty." I was just about to leave the meeting when I saw something that shook me to my core. My teacher walked in front of the camera with her naughty boyfriend. My dad! If that wasn't enough, my dad suddenly looked right at the screen and saw me. I quickly left and joined the link to the math class. 20 minutes later, he barged into my room.
"So now she's got you spying on me, has she? You creep."
Then he took away my phone and told Cody to make sure I only used the home computer for classes. I got really mad. I heard a noise from the computer. I had forgotten to log out of my class. Seeing Tom's face on the screen, I panicked and shut down my computer. Half an hour later, I heard police sirens outside my house. I could hear a lot of yelling and fighting. Cody let me out of my room and told me that the police had taken my dad away. Apparently, Brad had called the cops on him. The next day, there was a knock at our door. I opened it and saw my math teacher standing there.
"Hello, Samantha. I need to speak with your mom. Alone."
After what seemed like an hour, he finally left, looking happier than when he had shown up. Suddenly, my mom seemed to snap out of it. Within the month, she had lost like 50 pounds. She was happier and chirpier. Cody, on the other hand, went absolutely crazy without dad. He refused to go to school and would scream and fight with everyone. Things started to calm down when he shot me with a water gun in one of my Zoom classes and thought mom would give him a treat. But instead, she gave him a huge timeout. Sadly, though, one of my dad's friends bailed him out. As soon as he walked through the door, he saw mom happy and accused her of cheating on him. I'd had enough. I told him that I saw him cheating with my own eyes. He spun around to stare at me with fire in his eyes and ran right at me. I ducked out of the way just in time. Suddenly, my math teacher burst through the door and straight up tackled my dad to the ground. My mom screamed as a table broke, and Cody ran into the kitchen. I was about to follow him when he came back with popcorn and was cheering them on. I gasped as my teacher pushed him away. My mom told me and Cody to pack our things ASAP. Just as we were walking out, my dad suddenly screamed, "She's his, isn't she?" Everybody froze until my mom yelled back, "Yes, she is." Wait, what? I was my math teacher's daughter? Was that why my dad hated me so much? The next day, my mom and math teacher were telling me how he was my mom's old boyfriend, but then grandma forced mom to marry dad. That's when Brad walked in and said, "Hey, dad, you're my stepbrother." I blurted out in shock, but he just laughed and told me he was adopted. It was our first day all together, but Cody was crying, "I want Dad." I told him it'd be okay, but when we woke up the next day, Cody was gone. We looked everywhere but couldn't find him. Thankfully, a neighbor saw him trying to hitch a ride and brought him back. But just when things started to look normal, Brad did something that shocked me. One day, my stepdad was panicking and looking for his wallet, so Brad volunteered to help him look for it and went straight to my school bag. I laughed. "Oh, trust me, it won't be there." I couldn't even finish my sentence because Brad took out the wallet and showed it to my stepdad, who shot me a shocked look. I had no idea what to say. Right then, my mom walked in her fancy dress and left with my stepdad for their date. I immediately turned to Brad. "How did you know to look there first?" Mom had given me and Cody a lecture about getting along with Brad, but this was insane. Brad, though, was innocent as ever. "You found my bag next to a box of balloons. I would never put my stuff there." "Are you accusing me of something? I've been here way longer than you have, and nothing's ever been stolen before. Who do you think they'll believe?" I couldn't believe he was going to ruin everything for me. I took out my phone to text my mom, but Brad quickly swiped it from my hands. "You've been taking all of Dad's attention ever since you got here, and I'm sick of it." I started to cry just as Cody finally woke up from his nap and asked what was going on. Brad backed away from me, and I fell down on the living room sofa. I was crying into a pillow when, out of the corner of my eye, I could have sworn I saw a face staring at me. I quickly wiped my tears away and saw my dad's face just as he pulled away from the window. My heart was beating so fast I thought it would explode. I had to keep Dad out. I ran all around the house to make sure all the doors and windows were locked. Then I looked at Brad talking to Cody about whether donuts are overrated, and I knew that I had to face my fears and make a choice. I grabbed Brad's arm and quickly pulled him into the bedroom as he let out a yelp. I locked the door and made sure all the windows were covered. I would apologize to Brad and ask him for help. I dragged him inside. "Geez, you're strong." I ignored him and started apologizing. I explained that I was sorry for messing up his life and that I wasn't planning on stealing his dad's attention. We were both his kids. Brad shook me off. "Whatever." Then I finally told him that I'd just seen Dad at the window. "I don't see how that's my problem," he said. A few days later, I posted a selfie on Instagram with Brad. Immediately, Tom messaged me and asked me who it was. My heart did a little flip. Was he jealous? I decided to check. I told him that Brad was someone close to my heart, and Tom immediately called me. "Look, I'm sorry I try to hold it in, but there's no way I can see you with someone else, so I'm telling you. I love you, Sam." I started to laugh for a minute. Tom looked gutted. Just then, Brad came up behind me, and I thought Tom would pass out. "He's my stepbrother. I've only ever loved you, Tom, ever since the day at the carnival." After that, Tom and I officially started dating. But just as things started to settle down, one day I was in my room when Brad rushed in, dragged me outside, and started loudly yelling that he couldn't wait to get rid of me. Then Mom and my stepdad came back. Brad told everybody he had an announcement to make and started playing something on his phone. I was shocked as I heard my dad's voice. Dad was telling Brad that he saw Brad yelling at me and that they could team up to get rid of me. So tomorrow, he'd be waiting to kidnap me after school and would split the ransom money. My mom came over to me and hugged me as my stepdad walked away saying, "I'll go make some calls. He won't get out this time." Brad turned to me and said the words I'll never forget. "You're not alone anymore." I threw my arms around him. "You're the best brother anyone could ask for."